Hello everybody, my name is Michael Woodside. I'm an animator, and today I'll be teaching you how to draw Oswald the Lucky Rabbit. He is the character that Walt Disney created before Mickey Mouse, so it's got a lot of Mickey-isms in it, so I figured it's a good way to start the week. It's Classic Monday, and he's the most classic character that we could do, so let's talk about how we can get started. First off, I want to show you the supplies that we're using. Oswald is a character that's in black and white, so we're just going to be using our gray pencils today. So I have this lighter pencil, then I'll go over with my darker pencil later. For those of you who might be wondering who this class is for, this is for anyone who wants to learn how to draw. You don't need to know how to draw first, and I've seen a lot of posts recently from last week's drawing classes of people who thought maybe they weren't artists and then figured out they could do a pretty cool drawing from this. So it's a fun way to pass the time. We're all looking for different ways to pass the time. You know, so this is a cool way to do it, I think. First thing first, while you're learning, you need to know you're learning. So if it looks weird, that's okay. Just keep finishing. Go all the way to the end of the drawing, and then you can look back and see maybe where you wanted to change things and make some adjustments there. There's a lot of drawings that I do that I hate halfway through and I'm ready to throw away. But if I finish, I always decide more clearly how I can make it better the next time. So I'm encouraging you to do that because it works for me every time. It is a strange time in this world, so we want to make sure that we clean our hands before we start drawing. So I'm going to use this hand sanitizer. I was told that I was using it wrong, that I was drying too quickly, and you don't want to dry, you just want to let it sit on your hands. I didn't even research that. I just trust a comment on Instagram. I'm sure they're true, you're good people. So I'm just going to put it on my hands and let it sit. And then we're going to start drawing. So I'm just going to move the camera over here and then we will get started. So let's make sure we're in focus. Cool. So at the beginning of every class, I always start with drawing circles because I feel like that's the best way to warm up. So I'm just going to do a bunch of circles over here on this side of the page. And what's nice about that is that this already makes my drawing technically ruined, right? I've already got some scratchy lines on there. We talked about it before, but a blank canvas is kind of a scary thing. So this does two things. It warms up our hands, our minds, and then it also helps us know that this page is a page for learning. It's not going to be a final perfect drawing. So for those of you that were able to join me this past weekend, we did a live doodle session where I was drawing my corgi. Jack the Fire Truck is his name. I draw him all the time. Actually, before all these drawing with woodsy things started, that's mostly what I was drawing before, but I figured this is a cool way to get people's minds off of everything. So we were looking at how I drew him and how I would approach things differently or the same when I'm drawing my own things. So a lot of it comes from practice and continuing to go over and over these shapes. In fact, before teaching you how to draw Oswald, I practiced a bunch so that I would know exactly where the shapes go. He's a pretty simple guy, and if you drew Mickey with us before, you already know a lot of the shapes. So as I'm doing these circles, look at my arm. My whole arm is moving around, and it's not just my fingers moving. I'm trying to draw bigger circles too because Oswald is so easy that today we're going to draw the whole body. So I'm going to leave room for that, but just moving my arm around and kind of warming up the muscles. Let's see. And I'll show you real quick if you're new why we're kind of allowed to draw this scratchy. So let's say that we're happy with how this looks. If I just go in with a darker pencil and start accentuating certain lines, kind of helps those other lines go away. Even if I'm scratchy with a darker line, it helps those initial noodles go away. So this is a kind of a cool way to get pretty far in your drawing without having to put down a new sheet of paper. Might as well get this little guy. Almost reminds me of like, this is Jupiter and his little moon. Okay, I'm a nerd. Okay, so for Oswald, we're just gonna start with a circle right about in the center of the page. And I'm gonna draw mine kind of big so that we can see all the different details.
So I'm just drawing this kind of loosely, moving my whole arm around, starting with my shoulder, to make sure that I'm getting a full rotation. So, say we have our circle here. I'm going to show you a little tool that I use. If you've done this before, you've seen it. But this is a ping pong ball that I put these horizontal, vertical and horizontal lines on there so that we can see why we draw those lines on the characters. If the character is looking straight at us, we might have it like this. And then if it's looking up to the side, it might be over here and here. And this just gives us really quick landmarks to let us know which character or which direction the character is facing. So I think for Oswald, we're just going to draw him looking straight at us. Let me grab him. And to do that, we're just going to move it right down the middle of the face vertically. It's something to check out before you draw that line, if you can, is to do long strokes just with your arm. So instead of doing it with my hand or slowly, see how this got this weird bump in it? If I just move my whole arm, practicing over here, then I can get a more consistent straight line. And then I'm going to do the horizontal line. And that's going to be a little less than halfway up. Not all the way down, just almost halfway. So you see how I kind of have like a little line that came off over here? That's fine. When your lines aren't perfect, that is expected at this stage. That's why it says scratching. Okay, so we are set up for Oswald's head. I've left a little room in the top of the page because he has these big ears. And then on the bottom of the page is going to be his body. So let's just start with the head. So if you remember from Mickey, Mickey had this big nose right in the middle that was really round, right there. Oswald is kind of similar shape, but it's just a little smaller. So Oswald's going to practice it over here to a little like that. So Oswald is a rabbit. His first cartoon came out, I think it was 1927. The Disney cartoon, and he was before Mickey. Mickey was 1928, so it's pretty popular. I read that he was chosen to be a rabbit because most of the other characters at the time in the 20s were cats, like Felix. They're popular characters at the time, so Disney tried to find something different. So that is our nose. So one difference between Oswald and Mickey, just as a head start, is Mickey's cheeks went outside of the head, right? Do you remember? But Oswald's face is all inside the circle. So since we have this circle, if we wanted, we could actually just darken it because this is our full head shape. So just do that now just to help indicate, because it's pretty scratchy over here. I don't ever use an eraser, especially on this program, because I feel like if I erased, I would never stop doing that. So, okay, let's move on. So he's got eyes pretty similar to Mickey's, but they're totally colored in black. So they're on top of this line, and they're just long ovals. So an oval, if you don't know, is a circle that's just been pulled in either direction. Like a stretched water balloon. So let's go ahead and do that little Mickey cheeks, the mask over here. So starting from the bottom of the circle, I'm just going to arc up and over like that. Kind of like a little candy cane over here. I did the same thing on the other side, since I've already done it, just to make sure that they're the same size. So we have these little mirrored candy canes, and then the middle of the head on Mickey, it's like that. It's going to be almost exactly the same, so we're just going to go up towards the top. not straight, it's a little arced around, and then it meets down here for this V, this little rounded V. In the past, we've talked about it, like, if you were drawing birds flying, you might draw them like this. So it's like a little bird right there. But it's not, thinking about it like a bird is almost maybe a little deceiving, because this line technically should connect into this line. So it's just how we're separating this part of the shape, but they all flow together. So doing that on the other side. Okay, so let's go ahead and finish off the face. We're just gonna give him a big smile. So he's got those cheeky lines here. Do the other one over here so that I know where it's going. And they're about the same height. And then we're just gonna give him a nice closed mouth because we're gonna draw the whole body and we wanna make sure we have time for that. So it's just gonna be a rounded line that kind of follows the path of the circle around. A happy little rascal. So I'm not going to color it in yet. A lot of these spaces are just going to be colored in black, but I want to wait to do that so that we don't smudge too much. So let's give him his ears. Mickey's ears, if you remember, are these rounded circles here, but Oswald's ears are kind of like squared off rounded rectangles. So kind of like that. And they come off from here. I'll just draw them here. Make them as big as you like. They're kind of, if you look back at the cartoons, they're not totally consistent. I'm just giving them straight ears going up. So I'm making this adjustment because I looked back on this side and this part felt a little wider than what I had done here. And remember, we're coloring all this in black, so it doesn't matter. You could put a little happy face in here. We're never going to see that. Okay, so before we start coloring anything in, I want to actually start drawing the body. And the belly of him is the same size as his head, pretty much. So just below the head, I'm going to leave a gap there, but not too big. Then draw another circle about as big as the head. Keep it light so that we can redefine the shapes later. Happy face is really distracting up in the ear right now, but what are you gonna do? Commit to the joke, Michael. So while we have it, let's just go ahead and connect the head to the body. And we're just going to do that with really straight lines that are kind of diagonal out. And you don't want to go all the way out to the side. He has this little bump here. So you want to make sure that you're connecting to a point that isn't going to make it straight all the way to the round, which is probably what we would do nowadays, but specific to his design at that time. So let's give him some feet to stand on. So starting here at the bottom of the legs, sorry, the bottom of the body, we're gonna add a line about here that looks like kind of if you took a point like that and then made it really round. So let's go ahead and do that over here. His legs are really fun, so there isn't, I'm excited to see what everyone does with it, because there's not like one way to do it. It's really cute. So he has pretty thick legs, so I'm gonna do the other part of the leg right there. And then arc this down. Kind of a weird tube. You see that tube? So he's a rabbit, so he's got really big feet. I'm gonna draw this part flat on the ground. And I made it pretty long. Rabbit feet. And then from here, just gonna close that off. And these bumps here are the toes, so we wanna make sure that it's a little higher here than it is from here to here. It's a fun little shape. So since we've drawn this leg, let's go ahead and draw the other leg too. It's gonna be the same kind of thing. Again, so much of them is colored in too, so you don't have to be too precious with your lines. You're gonna be, by the end of it, it's gonna look like we did it all on purpose. And everyone's gonna be like, well, I didn't know you could draw. People still tell me that. All right, so let's give him some little shorts. So Mickey has shorts and Oswald should have shorts too. So starting from kind of a little bit into the belly here. You know how when we would do these circles here, let's imagine this is the circle for the shorts. It kind of tilted down a little bit. So it's got this little bit of an arc to it. So let's go ahead and do that here. So back in the 20s, it's interesting, the original animators who were animating Mickey were animating to make him consistent. They would actually trace a quarter for his head, and then I believe it was like a dime for the ears. It looks like they kind of did a similar thing for Oswald. So if you want to draw him again at the same size as the classic animators, you could just trace some quarters for the head and the body. Okay, so since they're shorts, we got to give him the little pant legs down here. Cool, so I'm going to put one arm on his hip, and then other arm is going to be waving. So to do that, I'm going to do a similar kind of shape to this leg tube, where it goes out from around here because the shoulder is raised up. And then come back there. See, it's pretty similar to that shape. And then just like that, we're going to bring the arm in here. And then I'm gonna draw the hand, and the hand is gonna be, it's almost like a circle, but since he's pushing it against his belly, I'm gonna make it a little bit squashed, like that. I'm just gonna draw like that, so it's still, we're able to see through it here, because we're gonna color all this in. And let's put the other arm out, waving. So I'm just going to draw a line out here. Again, it doesn't really matter how... You can make it really long if you wanted. What's nice about this era of cartoons is that the physics were not really that big of a deal to them. They were having a lot of fun. So if he had a tail, he could pull his tail and his ears might get shorter. So they were doing all kinds of crazy stuff back then. It's fun if you look back at it because they're just sort of inventing it. I know a lot of Oswald cartoons are on the internet. He only recently came back into the Disney family. Walt Disney was traveling to New York to go talk to the person who was helping him make the cartoons in the Universal was the company. And he, I think was trying to negotiate for more money and then was actually told that he could get less money. And so he lost the rights to Oswald, the character he created. And on his way back to California, he thought of Mickey Mouse. So if it wasn't for this guy, we wouldn't have had Mickey. And Disney, Universal had had it for all that time, all these other companies had acquired him, and only, I think it was 2006, I say recently, not that recent, but considering how long ago this was, Disney got him back. And so he was in this short that we got to animate called Get a Horse, which I think played before Frozen in 2013. But he was animated in the computer. And then also in 2D later. So there's a lot of really fun Oswald history. A lot of Disney fans love Oswald. I'm going to draw a little circle here for the hand, just like we had there. But it's not squashed because he's not pressing up against anything. And he has four fingers because he's a classic cartoon. So we're going to give him one thumb here. And the shapes of the fingers are just kind of little boxes. It's really easy shapes for anyone to draw. He's the right guy to start for on a Monday, I think. If we get a full body on a Monday, that's awesome. Normally those are saved for later. So now comes the easy part. You have your Oswald. We just got to color in the parts that are supposed to be black. It can get a little confusing, so follow along with me. I'm going to start up here at the top left. I'm right-handed, so starting at the left lets my hand move across the page in a way that feels natural. So normally at this point we would sort of outline the parts that we want to keep, but since we're coloring it in, I think that's going to do it for us. So I'm going to start up here. And then the happy face is gone. See, you can do whatever you want in there. So it's the same part, like Mickey has this mask that's black. Color in the same kind of parts black. And while I'm coloring it in, I try to do everything on the same path. So up here I decided to go horizontally. I want to make sure that all the way down I'm going horizontal. And then the ears, I'm going to go just up the length of the ear. So I'm not switching, I'm not going different directions. And that way I think I can keep it consistent. Go ahead and do the eyes. So the eyes, the whole thing is black. To the nose as well. I always love the story of Oswald and the birth of Mickey, because it feels like that could be the end of a lot of stories, is, you know, Walt sort of made his name with this character of Oswald and then lost him. And it could have been done. He could have just decided, well, I'm done here. But he, we know, was a guy of many ideas, so he was able to sort of pivot and find a new character. And Oswald sort of fell away as Mickey took over. And they worked on a Mickey short kind of in secret, his main animator's name is Ub Iwerks. And actually his Ub Iwerks, I believe it's his granddaughter, is the one who does some of the documentaries on, if you've seen them, the Imagineering Story. Leslie Iwerks. But he was sort of a pioneer for Disney, and he animated Mickey's first short all on his own. It's a short called Plane Crazy. And that was all done in secret, so that no one would know that Walt had another thing coming. And you know what happens next. I get a job. Some stuff happened in between there. See, we don't really have to darken any lines because we're coloring everything in. We're gonna leave the shorts white. And we're gonna do this arm. Reminds me of Vanellope's hair, but there's smaller pieces, so it feels like I accomplish something every time I finish it in, where Vanellope had that giant hair. Okay, so that's the top of Oswald. His legs are also colored in, so I'm going to sharpen. Now looking at it, I might actually darken in the mouth just a little bit. Grab a paper. So there's a couple extra little details I want to add that feel more like that silent era of filmmaking. I'm going to add these little guys, some lines that just kind of follow outside the V, like an extra V. Sometimes Oswald would have eyes that were like, they were like this, where he could have like actual eyeballs, and I saw a cartoon where a bird pulled at them. It just did all kinds of crazy stuff, so this sort of allows them, it could be a design thing, or it could be, it's always changing. Could be like part of the eyebrows. And then we could do another line outside of the mouth if we wanted. Just little things like that help give it some energy. Lastly, it's a silent cartoon, so at some point he would wave and then whatever he said would pop up on screen in like a little dialogue bubble. So to do that, I'm just gonna write, "Hi." These are the lines coming off it. It's a simple Monday, but it's a fun character. And what's cool about Oswald's fun shapes is that because they're so simple, you can sort of put him in whatever pose you like. So if you want to have him from the side, remember the circle is the head, always. And then he's got the ears, we're just going to draw the ears. And then let's give him a body here. Just do whatever you like with it. So there's a lot of really fun things you can do with Oswald. It'd be great to see people's different poses with him now that they learned how to use him. So I think we're probably done, and it's earlier than normal. Before we're done though, we have to sign it. And there we go, Oswald. So to share your drawing, we have the hashtag drawing with Woodsy. Please go ahead and share it with that. You can also tag me in it if you want to tag me in your stories. My Instagram name is Anna Woodsy. That's also on Twitter. Those are the two best ways to share your drawings, I think. And then at the end of the day, we always share the drawings together. So I put them in my stories, and then people can go back and look at everyone who drew him throughout the day. So that is Oswald. Cool. I'll move this back over here.
Okay, so let's just check, make sure we're good, and we are good. Cool. So thank you for joining me today. I hope you had a good time with Oswald. He's a fun, simple character. He's the original classic Monday character. I'm gonna clean up my hands while we're talking, because now my hands are covered in pencil, so gotta make sure that we're clean. If you haven't signed your drawing yet, be sure to sign it and then take a picture of it. Put it online. If you thought maybe you wanted to give up halfway through, he's a simple character. You can go back and now you know the whole shape, so you can come and finish the drawing. So I'd love to see you finish drawing. If you want to post it on Instagram or Twitter using Drawing with Woodsy. And I guess we'll see it later. Thank you for joining me today. As always, just because we're separated doesn't mean we need to be alone. So this has been fun, and I hope you had a good time. I'll see you next time. Bye now.